Okay, we are in Likutey Moharan Torah Yud Dalid. Torah Yud Dalid in Likutey Moharan is called LeHamshich Shalom, and we are in middle of Ot Bet of Torah Yud Dalid. Rabbi Nachman is explaining to us in this Torah LeHamshich Shalom how to bring peace into the world, how to bring Hashem's peace upon us. And Rabbi Nachman says that the way to do this is there's a formula, right? Everything in Likutei Moharan is a formula. Likutei Moharan is full of formulas. In every line, there's another formula. Okay, and so there's a formula in this as well. How do you draw peace? Rabbi Nachman said that that's dependent on first elevating and returning the honor and the glory of Hashem to its source. The source of honor and glory is yira, is fear, awe. And so when you have awe of the great honor and glory of Hashem, then that is the experience that comes from, that's experiencing kavod, honor of Hashem, glory of Hashem in its source, in a place of awe. Okay, so that's what it means. When you experience awe from the great glory of Hashem, from the great honor of Hashem, how glorified Hashem is. So that is the experience that comes from the glory of Hashem being connected with its source, with the fear, with awe. Okay? And so, but how do you do that? How do you accomplish that? So this is the next part of the formula. That's the beginning of Ot Bet. Rabbi Nachman says that the way to elevate and to return the honor, the glory of Hashem to the fear, to the awe, is through Torah Chesed, through a Torah of loving kindness. It means Torah that is selfless. When you're teaching Torah selflessly and spreading the Torah to others, you're not learning Torah for your own gain, for your own knowledge, for yourself to grow only. Your intention is also to help others. It's to spread the light of Hashem so that others may also taste the sweetness and the life energy of the tree of life, of the Eitz HaChaim, of the Torah. That's what Torah of loving kindness is, a Torah of Chesed. And when you do that, we know from the Zohar, very famous Zohar that Rabbi Nachman brings about Yitro, that the great name of Hashem is glorified in the greatest way. The honor of Hashem is increased in the greatest way when those that are farthest from Him return to Him. And we see that by Yitro. The Zohar says when Yitro returned to Hashem, he was the greatest, he was the one that's farthest away from the Ribbono Shel Olam. He was the priest of all the idol worships, all the idol worship in the world, all the idols in the world. He was an expert in the worship of all the idols of the world. And for him, when he comes back to Hashem, that causes the greatest kavod of Hashem to be increased. Hashem's honor is increased in the greatest way. And so that comes from spreading Torah, right? So when you spread Torah, which is what we're going to see about in the continuation now in the Likutei Moharan, but I'm just kind of giving you the outline a little bit. When you spread Torah, when you teach Torah to others, which is called loving Torah, Torah Chesed, a Torah of kindness, right? That's Torah that you're teaching to others in order to benefit them, in order to give them that light of Hashem. So that is the way that you will cause those sparks of holiness to convert from the other side, from the side of darkness, to convert back to the side of holiness. That's the way that you're going to cause those people that were disconnected from Hashem, those sparks of holy souls, to return, right? And when you cause them to return, you are increasing the honor and the glory of Hashem in the greatest way, as we saw in the Zohar about Yitro. So what comes out from there is that the way to cause Hashem's honor, Hashem's glory to be increased in the greatest way possible is through spreading Torah, through the Torah of love and the Torah of kindness, right? The Torah that you spread in order to benefit, in order to bring the light of Hashem to the farthest realms, what's called, like with Chabad, the Rebbe was very fond of saying, Yefutzu ma'inotecha chutza, right? That the springs should be spread outward into the farthest reaches of humanity, into the farthest reaches of the universe, of existence, so that light of Hashem should be should spread out throughout all of existence. And that's what it means to increase the honor of Hashem. The farther the light of Hashem spreads, just like a king. What is the glory of a king measured by? It's measured by how far his name and his influence reaches, right? And if he's a king on, let's say, a tiny little city, he's not such a big king. But if he is a king and he rules over the whole world, now imagine if he rules over every part of the world, over even the darkest corners of the world. Everyone recognizes that this is the king, and everyone is his subject, and everyone honors him and respects him and follows his laws and follows his words. And more than that, they love him because they recognize that everything is from him. They recognize that not only are they subjects of this king, but also every aspect of their existence is only because of this king. And so that's the greatest honor. That's the greatest glory possible. That's what it means to increase Hashem's glory in the greatest way. And that happened all because of Torah Chesed. It happened because of the Torah of kindness, where you're teaching Torah in order to benefit others, to spread the light of Hashem in the farthest realms of the earth, in the farthest realms of humanity, right? In the farthest reaches of people, of souls. Okay, so let's see how that continues now. ועכשיו, so says Rabbi Nachman, עכשיו, הכבוד בגלות. Now, we are unfortunately experiencing that the glory of Hashem is still in exile. כי עיקר הכבוד אצל העקום. Because nowadays, the main glory of Hashem is found by the non-Jews. The main, not the kavod of Hashem, the main honor, the aspect of glory. Glory nowadays, and honor and respect, power and influence, these are all synonyms for that same sphera, the sphera of Malchut. These are all different expressions of Malchut, right? Honor, glory, power, respect, influence, all of that is Malchut. And now, exile is all about Malchut of Hashem instead of that characteristic, king, being a king and being a ruler, instead of it being by Hashem, by the most deserving and the most worthy ruler, the only deserving, the only worthy ruler, because everything is from him. But the checker, the darkness, and the falsehood in this world, the concealment and the illusion is so terrible that that aspect of Malchut has been taken into exile, and now it's attributed and connected and found by those people that do not acknowledge even they don't even acknowledge the existence of Hashem, even though everything, their whole existence and every aspect of their existence is from Hashem. They don't acknowledge the existence of Hashem. And that's where awe is found. That's where glory is found. That's where honor is found. And that's where influence and power is found, is by those people in a disconnected way, disconnected from Hashem. And so that's the meaning, the definition of what the Zohar calls Shechinta Begaluta. The Shechina is in exile, which means the Malchut is in exile. V'anachnu b'nei Yisrael shfalim v'nivzim. And instead of Am Yisrael, we are the nation, the chosen nation. We are chosen by the King of all kings. We are chosen by the Creator of all of existence. All of creation is constantly being created by this King of all kings. And He chose us out of the millions and billions and trillions of creatures and entities and energies and souls and angels and all of the universe. And in this physical world, Hashem chose us as His firstborn, as His chosen nation, His nation. And so it would be appropriate that that glory and that honor of Hashem should only be found either by Hashem and by His Son, by His chosen nation. Who should be the most glorified nation, the most glorified people in this world? It should be those that are the representation of that King, who is the King of all of the universe. But we see just the opposite. We see the people that are the most disrespected, the most lowly and the most disgraced among all nations are the B'nai Israel. And that glory and that respect and that power and that influence is found by the persecutors of Am Yisrael. Right? So that's the definition of the Shechina and the Malchut being in exile. But the exile will end. There's an end to the exile. ולעתיד לבוא שיתגלה כבודו מבין החושך כמו שכתוב ונגלה כבוד השם, כי אז יתו כולם לעובדו שכם אחד, אז אמרו בגויים, נכו ונלכה באור השם, וכבו נקרא אור כמו שכתוב והארץ העירה מכבודו. So says Rabbi Nachman, when the exile, when we're delivered from this exile, when we have a redemption בעזרת השם soon, so then the honor and the glory of Hashem will be revealed from out of the darkness. It will be returned and taken out of that darkness, out of that concealment. It will be returned to its rightful place. As we know from the Pasuk in Yeshayahu, the prophecy about the Geula, it says, "V'nigla kivod Hashem." It says that the honor of Hashem will be revealed, because now it's concealed, now it's hidden, now it's hidden, now it's disconnected from Hashem, and it's found by those that are undeserving of it, right? The most undeserving, right? And the Pasuk in Yeshayahu says, Ki az yatu kulam ne'ovdo shechem echad. At that time, in the time of the redemption, in the time of the Geula, they will all, the glory of Hashem will be revealed, and all everyone will see the glory of Hashem. And at that time, it says in the Pasuk, that everyone will serve Hashem with one heart, with one intention, in one way, meaning everyone will be unified to serve Hashem. אז ימרו בגויים נחו ונלכה באור השם. And then the Pasuk says, then all the nations will say, let us walk in the light of Hashem. Says Rabbi Nachman, what does it mean that they will all say, let us walk in the light of Hashem? What is the light of Hashem? The light of Hashem, says Rabbi Nachman, is the honor, the glory of Hashem. All the nations will come to serve Hashem, to glorify His name, and to walk in that glory, meaning that they will subject themselves. They will completely give themselves over to glorifying Hashem's name. They will completely align themselves with this goal, with this intention to glorifying Hashem's name. And that's what it means that everyone will say, all the nations will say, let us walk in the light of Hashem, because the light is the honor, the glory. Rabbi Nachman brings a place where we see that light is also another word for honor of Hashem. The kavod of Hashem. As it says in Pasuk in Yechezkel, that the earth was illuminated, lit up by the glory, by His glory, by the glory of Hashem. Which is interesting, because or is also something that we always see connected to Chochmah. Chochmah, the sphere of Chochmah, is the sphere of that's connected, that is represented also by this sense of sight, of seeing, of eyes. We spoke about this in the previous Torah. So Or, which is light, which is something that we sense with our eyes, is connected to Chochmah, which is connected to the eyes. And now we see also that it's connected to Kavod. And Kavod, which is glory, is Malchut. And Malchut and Chochmah have a special relationship, and we spoke about this in previous classes, where the Arizal and the Zohar teaches us, Abba Yasad Brata, the father builds up the daughter. The father is the Chochmah, and the daughter is the Malchut, and the Malchut is built up by the Chochmah. And so many times we have similarities between the Chochmah and the Malchut. Okay, and so this is one of them, where we see that the Aretz, which is the Malchut, right, Heira, was illuminated, lit up, mikvodo, from His glory, from His honor, which is kavod, is also the light of the Malchut, and that light is drawn from the Chochmah. Why? Another place in the Likutei Moharan, and this is a little bit of an advanced idea, but I'm just going to mention it here. There's a place later on in the Likutei Moharan where Rabbi Nachman brings this idea of kavod, the connection between kavod and Chochmah. So even though Kavod is the aspect of Malchut in many places, in most places, but Kavod is also connected to Chochmah. And in that place, Rabbi Nachman brings a reference, this Gemara that says, Im av ani, Hashem says, Im av ani ayek vodi. If I am your father, then where is my glory? If I am truly your father, then why aren't you treating me like your father? Why aren't you honoring me? Why aren't you respecting me? Where is my glory? Im av ani ayek vodi. If I am your father, then where is my glory? And so Rabbi Nachman says that we see from here that the aspect of glory, of kavod, of honor is something that's connected to the father aspect. And the father aspect is always known as chokhmah. In Kabbalah, the sphere of chokhmah is called also Abba, right? The Zohar calls the sphere of chokhmah Abba. Chokhmah is Abba, Ima is Bina. The father is chokhmah and the mother is Bina. And so we see kavod and or kavod, glory, respect, and light. We see it by chokhmah. And we also see kavod, honor and glory, and light by malchut. And so that's what I'm saying, that there is an interesting relationship, because the malchut is receiving this light from the chokhmah. In the place of chokhmah, it's supernatural. It's beyond grasp. It's impossible to receive it because it's so beyond our current experience, our current existence. And the malchut receives that and is built from that, right? It's like the father that builds up his daughter, his beloved daughter, the princess, as we see in many places also in the stories of Rabbi Nachman. Okay, so moving on, the nations of the world will say in the time of the Geula, let us go, let us walk in the light of Hashem. What's the light of Hashem? That's the honor and the glory of Hashem. Because when they return, then the glory of Hashem is returned. And when is the glory of Hashem returned? In the time of the redemption, in the time that all the nations will come and return to Hashem and will say, and they will subject themselves to this goal, to this ultimate intention of all creation, of serving Hashem and glorifying His name. Ot Gimel, part three. Ve'i efshar likaren. So now that we've established the importance of bringing back those lost souls, causing those sparks of holiness that are on the other side, on the side of darkness, to convert and return to the side of the holiness. And we said also in previous year that this also applies to Jews that were lost, or Jews that just don't know better. They weren't given a Jewish education, and they didn't have a proper Jewish background, or for whatever reason, they're in this current point, they're disconnected from Hashem, and you're helping them to return to Hashem. That causes and then glorifying of Hashem's name, increases Hashem's glory. Really interesting point I'm just going to say here. There's a sefer from Rabbi Natan, the greatest Talmud of Rabbi Nachman. And he wrote a couple of editions of Likutei Moharan in short. Okay, at first they called it Kitzur Likutei Moharan. Okay, the short version of Likutei Moharan. And he takes each point, each one of the Torahs, and he shortens it into more practical points, into more practically applicable ways of understanding each one of these paragraphs and each one of these ideas. And then eventually, that turned into a book, a sefer by Rabbi Natan called Likutei Etzot. Okay, and that's where you have all this advice that he organized in categories based on different concepts. You have one about the tzaddik, and one about loving Hashem, one about fear for Hashem, one about prayer, one about all of the different parts, ideas in Yiddishkeit and Torah and mitzvot. And he goes through each one of these categories, and he brings from all the different places in the Likutei Moharan the advice, the practical advice that applies to that category. But originally, they're one of the original editions of that. Before it became Likutei Etzot, it was Kitzur Likutei Moharan. It was Likutei Moharan, like a summary of Likutei Moharan of each Torah. And so over there, one of the things that he says, and it's, I think, also found in Likutei Etzot, connected to this Torah, connected to this paragraph, he says, because we see that the greatest increase of Hashem's glory, the greatest honor for Hashem, is when those that are far from Hashem return to Hashem, therefore a person can never have the excuse to say that they are too far from Hashem in order to return to Him, that they are too far from Hashem in order to serve Hashem, in order to fulfill the mitzvot, in order to learn Torah. No one in the world can ever excuse themselves and answer that the reason why they are not connecting to Hashem and they're not serving Hashem is because they're too far from Hashem. That logic does not exist Because if you think you're so far from Hashem, so then specifically you, when you return to Hashem, you will cause the greatest honor to Hashem. So the farther you think you are from Hashem, the greater the honor you will bring to Hashem when you return to Hashem. And when you daven, even though you feel so disconnected, and you stand up and you pray, even you feel so disconnected, and you sit down and you learn, even though you feel so disconnected, and you shomer Shabbat, and you follow the Torah, and you follow the mitzvot, and you put a coin in tzedakah, and you help out somebody with some kindness, that will bring the greatest glory to Hashem. And so there's a bigger request and there's a bigger demand from above that you specifically, you should serve Hashem rather than the one that's sitting in the Beis Medrash the whole day, rather than the one that has the greatest Torah background and the greatest Jewish background and he's holy and he's an angel and all that. From you, there's a greater request and there's a greater wish from above, from Hashem, that you should serve Hashem. Because when you serve Hashem from your lowly place, from that place of disconnection that you think you are on, that will bring the greatest glory and the greatest honor to Hashem more than anyone else. Amazing chizuk from Rabbi Natan on this piece. So let us move on. Od gimel, ve'i efshar lekarev et hagerim im ba'ale ha'teshuva ela al yedei Torah, kemo shekatuv, yafutzu ma'ayonotecha chutzah she'tzareich lahashkot otam she'em mibachutz. Rabbi Nachman brings this pasuk we mentioned before that the Lubavitch Rebbe used to speak about a lot. So Rabbi Nachman says that it's impossible to convert, to attract the converts, and to cause the people that were disconnected from the Torah to return to Hashem without the Torah. It's impossible to do so without the Torah, because the Torah is the catalyst. It's what causes those they are on the one side, on the side of darkness, and the disconnected side, to convert to the side of connection, to be reconnected to Hashem. That's the catalyst, that's the Torah. As we see in the Pasuk in Mishlei, Yafutzu Mayanotecha Chutza, your wellsprings will spread outward. So says Rabbi Nachman, we learn from here that you have to give them to drink, to those that are outside, that are far away. Give them to drink from the sweet waters of life, the sweet waters of heaven, right? From Gan Eden. The waters of Gan Eden are the waters in the Torah, as the Zohar teaches us, right? And that river that comes out of Eden, that's the Torah itself. And when you teach it to others, you are giving them to drink from the sweet waters of life, the sweet waters of Eden. And those waters are what will cause them to know the proper way, to know the way of Hashem, to be filled with the divine consciousness. And that's what will cause them to return to Hashem. להודיע להם הדרך יהיה לחובה. וזה שאמרו חכמינו זיכרונם יברכה, אין כבוד אלא תורה. וזהו, אם תוציא יקר מזולל, ואמרו חכמינו זיכרונם יברכה, אלו שמקרבים בני אדם לעבודת השם יתברך. כי זהו נקרא מוציא יקר, היינו כבוד מזולל מזילותא דגלותא. So says Rabbi Nachman, now that we have established that the way to honor Hashem, to glorify Hashem's name, to return the honor of Hashem that is currently in exile, to return it to its appropriate place, to return it to Hashem, that glory and that honor should be the glory and the honor of Hashem. The way to do that, and the only way to do that, is by spreading Torah. That's why Torah is called honor. That's why Torah is called kavod. As we know, the famous Mishnah, end of Masechet Avot, the Mishnah, end of Masechet Avot says, Ein kavod ela Torah. There is no honor but Torah, meaning that the aspect of honor, the aspect of kavod, is Torah, which is very interesting. Because, as we said earlier, kavod, honor and glory, is something that is also connected to malchut, and it's also connected to chachma. And the Torah is also connected to malchut, and it's also connected to chachma. As we know, oraita mechochma nafkat, as the Zohar says, the Torah comes out of chachma. It's drawn from chachma. That's why the reshit is reshit chachma. Reshit, the beginning, is another name. It's a code name for Chochmah. And that's why the Zohar brings that Bereshit is Bechuchmita. The Targum of Bereshit is with Chochmah. Hashem created the world, right? With Chochmah. And also, Kavod, also Torah, is Malchut. As we know, Bimilachim Yimlochu, from Rabbi Nachman, right? Rabbi Nachman connected the idea of Torah to the malchut, because it's through the malchut, through the Torah, that kings, that rulers will rule. So the source for malchut is the Torah. So the Torah is really this light that comes from chokhmah and it builds up the malchut. Okay, so that's the honor, that's the glory of Hashem that is drawn, that's the light. It's the light, the or, and the kavod, which are synonymous. These are the same thing, the same aspect, and they're drawn from chokhmah, and they build up the malchut of Hashem. That's the greatest tikkun that you can do, is when you learn Torah and when you teach it to others, and you're spreading that river of sweet waters. Nachal novea mekor chokhmah, the water, the river that is flowing with the source of chokhmah. Okay, from the source of chokhmah, and you're spreading it out and you're letting it flow into the farthest reaches of the earth, and so that everyone will return to Hashem when they receive that light of Hashem, they will now be filled with the consciousness of Hashem, and that will cause all these sparks of holiness to return to Hashem. And that's why the Torah is called Kavod, because this is what Torah does. The function of the Torah is to return the Kavod of Hashem to Hashem, to return the glory of Hashem, to increase and to perfect and rectify the kavod, the malchut of Hashem. And that's why it also says in the pasuk, v'zeo im totzi yakar mizolel. The pasuk in Yirmiyah says, im totzi yakar mizolel. If you will take out the precious, yakar is the precious, mizolel. Zolel means from the vile, or from the lowly, from the lowliness of exile. ואמרו חכמים וזיכרונם מברכה, אלו שמקרבים בני אדם לעבודת השם יתברך. The Gemara in Masechet Baba Metzia makes a drasha, and they say, what is this? What is this pasuk referring to? What does it mean, someone who is taking out, redeeming and taking out the precious from the vile and from the lowliness of exile? What is that referring to? The Gemara says it's referring to those people that are returning, they are bringing close and returning others to serving Hashem. Right? Because that is their soul, their sparks of holiness, those precious souls, that's the precious that's referred to in this pasuk. But more than that, Rabbi Nachman says, when you return those souls to Hashem, you are causing the honor of Hashem that was disconnected and was in exile to be returned to Hashem. And the kavod of Hashem is the precious, because precious, something that's precious, is just another word for something that is for honor and for respect. When you recognize the preciousness of something, you are respecting and honoring that thing. Okay, so when you're returning the precious from the lowliness of exile, the precious from the vile, you are in essence, you are returning the honor, the experience of Hashem being so precious, you're returning that to Hashem. The experience of someone being precious or something being precious, you're attributing it now to Hashem. You're returning it to Hashem. There's nothing precious but Ribono Shel Olam. And anything precious that you find anywhere in the world, it's only because of a tiny spark of Hashem that is shining within that thing. And so all precious and all honor and all respect and all glory belongs to who? Belongs to Hashem. And so that's what you do. That's what you cause when you're spreading Torah outward. You're spreading those wellsprings of Hashem's light outward, and then those sparks in the farthest places recognize, wow, this is precious. Hashem is precious. They recognize in the Torah that Hashem is light, and Hashem is the real light, and Hashem is the only light, and Hashem is precious, and Hashem is the real precious, and Hashem is the only precious, and Hashem is honorable, and Hashem is the only honorable, and Hashem is only worthy of honor, only worthy of glory, only worthy of respect is the Ribono Shel Olam. And they return, and they convert, and they return to Hashem. And so that's why the Torah is called Kavod, and that's what it means, returning and taking out the precious from the vile, from the lowliness of exile. And that's why the Gemara says that's referring to those people. That's referring to those people that are taking out those precious souls. They're drawing people back to the service of Hashem. אוקיי? מקרבין בן אדם לעבודת השם יתברך, כי זהו נקרא מוציא יקר, היינו כבוד מזולל מזילותא דגלותא. Now that's what it means, taking the precious out of the lowliness of exile. וזהו רם על כל גויים השם, היינו כשעקו מודים ומשנחין, אזי על השמיים כבודו. Azayin italia kavod me'achoshecha. That's what it means in the pasuk in Tehillim. The pasuk in Tehillim says that Hashem is high above all nations. Okay, His glory is above all the heavens. Hashem is high above all nations. So that when does that happen? When is that experience? When is that revealed that Hashem is high above all nations? That means when the non-Jewish people acknowledge and praise Hashem, then Hashem's glory is above the heavens. That's the continuation of the pasuk. Ala shamayim kevodo. So ram al kol goyim Hashem. Hashem is high above all the nations. When all the nations of the world recognize that Hashem is high above them, that's the beginning of the pasuk. Ram al kol goyim Hashem. Hashem is high above all nations. So Rabbi Nachman explains, when all the nations of the world recognize that Hashem is high above them, that means when they acknowledge Hashem's greatness and Hashem's sovereignty and Hashem's the only precious one, the only glorified and the only deserving of glory and honor, and they praise Hashem, then the continuation of the pasuk in Tehillim is Al Shamayim Kevodo. Then Hashem's glory is above the heavens. That means you have elevated the glory of Hashem from out of the darkness to the highest of the highest places. And that's returning the glory of Hashem to its source. Ala shamayim kevodo. The kavod of Hashem is above, it's upon and above the heavens. Okay, it ascends from the darkness it was found, where it was found. In that darkness, in that concealed, disconnected place, in exile, it has now been returned and now it's been lifted above the heavens. And we'll see the continuation of this and the next year, Bezrat Hashem.